Another last one is, and this is something that is called the butt eraser. We've all used the word butt in our dialogues with people. A lot of times we don't realize that the word butt erases everything that came before it. So if you go into an employee and say, you're doing a great job, but, well, subconsciously that employee already knows, I'm about to find out what I'm not doing right. Yeah. So you have to remember when to use but and when not to use it, and sometimes replace it with and. You're doing a great job, and I'd like to talk to you about ways we can get it even better, as a much better statement than you did a great job, but, and then they go, well, you didn't really mean that. So that's a subconscious thing, not only on the receiver, but on the sender's part. If you use it judiciously, then you can be a much better mentor as you move forward.
So good little tactics in there. So start off with some kind of phrase that gets natural agreement.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Where people can say, oh, yeah, we like this. Like, I wouldn't go to you and say, wasn't that a great baseball game last night?
Right.
That wouldn't work.
For me,
that
no.
That wouldn't
because
work
my
well
eyes would glaze over, and I'd say, his mouth is moving, but I'm thinking about what I got to get at the grocery store today.
But we talked about find something else, though, that we could start off with agreement and then using and to build momentum.
Right.
I like that.
Using and. So another example of that, what everybody agrees on, 100% of the world's population agrees that the Beatles are the best band ever. Gosh, and so you can always start.
Let this down. You know, I can just see it. I can see it right now. Someone's going to send me a Beatles bobblehead.
I hope so. You are the only person I have honestly ever met. I've had people who go, well, they're great, but it's just not my stuff. You're the only person, like, I switched the channel. I'm
makes
like,
me unique and special.
Well, it does, doesn't it?
Everyone needs something.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, so I love that. So we have mindset and then mentoring.
Yep.
So we're kind of building that momentum.
Yep.
And then, so what's our next one?
So the next one is management. We're all trying to talk to ourselves about how to lead teams, and that's a necessary thing. And by the way, again, your team can be people in the office, it can be your family, it can be a church group, it can be whatever it is. But you're trying to help them understand, you know, why where you want to take them is a good place to go. And one of the things you have to do is talk to yourself on that front. And if you talk to yourself, then ultimately you can figure those things out and do it. So there's four kinds of leaders that are out there. People who lead with vision, people who lead with data, people who lead with warmth, or people who lead with details. So a visionary is Steve Jobs. We're all familiar with that. Data leaders, data is important in order to lead a team, but it's not necessarily, you can imagine somebody who comes in all data and no warmth or no vision. That's not going to be very inspiring. It's difficult to lead on that. Warmth is something that does lead, as long as you back it up with content, with reality. It can't just be charm. It's got to be charm, warmth, and also content and delivering on stuff. And then the final thing, the final kind of leader is a leader who leads with details. Here's how we're going to get there and all that sort of stuff. The two best or the two most appropriate are vision and warmth. That combination can be very, very good. It certainly worked with Steve Jobs. But that's all the stuff that you tell yourself, and understanding how to frame things up helps you become a better manager. And ultimately, then you can do everything that you're talking about there. I got one tip for the listeners in terms of how not to lead, how not to be a good manager if you're trying to build consensus with something. So we're talking about persuasion. We're all in organizations where we're trying to persuade our organization to do X or Y or Z. And one of the common mistakes that people make on that front is they go, I see that we should be turning left at this juncture instead of turning right. That's fine. But what they do is they come up with an email, and then they go out and send the email out to everybody. And what happens when you send an email to everybody is you get inauthentic responses. So you send out an email that says, we're at a juncture for our company, we need to turn left here. You send it out to everybody. And what ends up happening? Somebody hits reply all. Now, are they giving an honest, fair answer? No, they're giving an answer that makes them look good. I've got an opportunity here. And generally speaking, they're going to disagree with you, because it's safer to disagree and say, let's do the status quo, than it is to say, yes, let's turn the corner here and do something different. So once you send out a broadcast email and you start getting reply alls back, it's dead in the water. You're not going to persuade anybody. The secret is to go in and say one-on-one, build consensus, start with the person who you know is going to be the easiest to convince, get them. Then you go to the next person, you work your way up. And over the course of time, you're going to be able to say, hey, I've got five or six people who agree with me on this. Bob, I'm talking to you one-on-one in this email, but I've got five or six people who agree with me. Can we get you on board with this? Are you at least neutral to positive about this? Yeah, I am. And then you start building up, and then you go out to everybody and say, it looks like we're mostly agreeing that we should turn left at this juncture. Let's meet, have a face-to-face meeting, and hash this out.
Jamie, you said a lot there. I mean, there's a lot there. I mean, you really hit a lot of really important points.
Well, this is 100% of it. I know nothing else. So if you're impressed by this, don't be, because it's a vacuum after this. I'm trotting everything I know out right here for this podcast, just for you.
All happen right now, right here.
Right.